I had a damn pack.
Yeah.
That's right.
All right, Timothy, tell us about some of you've been around a long time. Who are some of the people you sparred?
I sparred with Mike Tyson. I sparred with Evander Holyfield. I sparred with Andrew Galata. I sparred with David Tua. I sparred with Julian Jackson. I sparred with former world champion Lupe Aquino. I sparred with Johnny Beast Mugabe. I sparred with James E. Kitchen. Mm-hmm. And I sparred with the Alicio and Alize Castillo, the Cubans, mm-hmm. down there. And I almost got a step-up fight with Thomas Hearns.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, out of all the guys you sparred, who was the most talented? Out of all the people you sparred with?
Jeremy Williams.
Why?
Because he was 6'2", 220 pounds. He's fast as a cheetah, hit like a truck. Hit like a truck. Jeremy Williams, a soul brother from out there in Long Beach, California.
Light-skinned brother
with all the tattoos.
Southpaw, right?
No, he's a right hand.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, he was a highly decorated amateur, world champion. He done won this, he done won that. All the way down, more decorations than the Christmas tree.
Yeah.
Then they turned it pro.
Yeah.
You know, he had already fought for the title. He was rated number 4 by the WBO, number six by the WBC.
Right.
And their Jeremy Williams, I mean, I took that ass whooping like a man. I mean, boy, he put it on me.
Yeah.
But I wasn't in no shape.
Yeah.
I went to camp out of shape. When I went on the next go around, like James Brown, the big payback.
Yeah.
That's right, brother.
Right, right.
But Jeremy Williams had the most talent.
Okay.
David Tua was flat-footed, come straight ahead. It take him time to get to you. When he cut the ring off, either you do or you don't.
Yeah.
That's right. And my jab was the key to David Tua. It was like Ali Frazier. He's steady coming, I'm steady sticking. He's steady trying to press, cut the ring off. Holyfield, it was love in every lick. And if loving Holyfield is wrong, I don't want to be right. And with Mike Tyson was the most vicious.
Yeah.
Yeah, he hit me so hard one day. He hit me so hard. I went home and called Geico. I said, I want to report a drunk driver. They said, what was he driving, sir?
Man, did Tyson try to bite your ear?
Nah, I had on earmuffs. Okay. I had on earmuffs. Tyson's a beautiful dude, man. In camp, back then, he took care of his sparring partners. You know, he's a beautiful dude. I told Mike, I said, you know, my mom was in the hospital. She was sick.
Okay.
I said, Mom, I'm going to, they want me to come spar with Tyson in Phoenix. I said, Mama, I don't want to go because you're sick. I want to see about you. She said, baby, you just go on out there and, you know, and work with Mike. And she said, you tell Mike, him and Muhammad Ali are my two favorite fighters. Mm-hmm. And you tell Mike, send me an autograph picture. So when I got to camp, I talked to Mike. I said, man, I'm glad to be here. I shook his hand. He said, man, I'm glad to have you. He said, where you from? I said, I'm from Louisville, Kentucky. He said, you know, my mama's sick and she wanted an autograph picture. She said, well, I got to talk to my cameraman, Frank, see if we got any. If we don't have none, we'll make one.
Yeah.
So that's what he did.
All right, man, I appreciate your time, Timothy. Man, what do you want to say to the people out there?
Just keep on tuning in. Keep your head up, keep God first, and you can be what you want to be if you trust in the Lord, and just work hard at it. Stay dedicated, stay true to people, and stay true to yourself, and last but not least, treat people right. That's where your blessings come from.
Yeah, you have it. Thanks for your time, Timothy.
Thank you.
This is Carla J.